Litora. Hey folks, welcome back to After Work Gaming. We are here checking out a game called Essence by OneVision Games. It is coming to Early Access on April 18th. They were good enough to give me a key to the game a little bit early so I can come and play around. I should probably start by addressing the elephant in the room. I have been gone for about 2 weeks, so I fully apologize. I will tell you guys about what has been going on with me in a minute, and try not to bore you too much, but just a little bit more about this game before I get into, you know, everything else. This, you know, I don't know too much about. Big surprise. I have tried to keep myself away from as many of the spoilers as possible. That said, I know it's an exploration game. I know that there are probably going to be some puzzles involved. And it's sort of open worldy in the sense that you can sort of wander around larger areas. But ultimately, I think the progression is somewhat paced. Or at least that's what I have come to believe. Maybe I am totally wrong. Now, as with all exploration games, we're going to take our time, we're going to look around the environment, we're going to learn the ins and outs, and we're going to push on as, you know, as and when we feel it's appropriate. I'm seeing something in the distance, but let's just keep looking around this little starter area. I've now figured out we can jump, we can run. I don't think there's a crouch. I can't, it's not one of the usual buttons. What? We are very naked. Okay, and the ground, which I guess is sand, maybe? Maybe it looks like it looks either wet or sparkly. Okay, so let's, how do I get out of here? There it is. Let's just go. I'm seeing something in the distance. I think that's a human figure or something. It's unclear whether, by the way, Litora, which is the thing that popped up in the beginning, is the name of this place or the name of, I don't know, of like this little Stonehenge megalith area, or if it's this particular world. I guess we'll find out as we continue on. Ooh, hello. Oh, we can. It's not the statue, it's this thing. It's like cube thing in his hands. I'm seeing some sort of polyhedron. I thought I... Oh, yeah, okay. So I was going to say, I thought it was with us when we were there in the Stonehenge area, and I guess this is kind of like our tour guide? Or, like, that's the thing we follow, essentially, in order to explore the environment? Okay, it's right over there. Okie dokie. What is this? Right? It's like floating rocks. All right, well, let's take care of this guy first, right? Let's grab this. This world. How did I come here? Why am I here? Those beings. Are they trying to show me something? Beings. This? Are you... No? Nothing? Okay, fine. Whatever. Let's go check out what this thing is. Ooh. Color. Very cool. Whoa! So cool. Alright, look at that. It's a heck of a wall. I'm assuming I gotta go through that gate. Right? Because isn't there one of these things floating around here somewhere? Thought I saw it floating around here somewhere. Alright, no idea. Never mind. Never mind. Come on, it was right over here, right? Oh, it's over there. Ooh. So right mouse button zooms in. And there it is. It's kind of bouncing around. You can kind of see the shimmer. And if it's over there, let's go this direction. Let's actually test this open world and see what else we can find before we move on. And as we're running around, since it doesn't seem like there's a lot, I just want to give you guys a heads up. I have been gone, like I said, for about 2 weeks. I apologize profusely for the fact that I haven't been playing with you guys. It basically went something like this. I was really busy at work, then I got very sick, and then I got very busy at work again, and I'm sort of in the middle of that right now, which is why I'm probably going to be able to make time for, you know, one video, two videos max. Tonight I made the decision that no matter what, given that I was almost gone for 2 weeks, I can't justify a longer hiatus. So I'm doing two videos, but I think for a little while afterwards, I'm probably going to do one, only because work is objectively insane. I'm talking like 14, 16, 17 hours a day, every day in the office, and then plus commute, plus everything else, that just doesn't leave any time for other things. So here we are, we're at the shoreline of what I can only imagine is a sea, some sort of body of water. I'm seeing giant nautilus shells, and then husks, or basically the skeletons of abandoned ships. I'm not really seeing, like, a lot of stuff. In a sense of, like, there's nothing to interact with, it's just visual storytelling, which, you know me, I'm all about. Pretty happy about that. We could probably swim across or swim out as far as we can, but you know what? That's not interesting. You guys don't want to see me run into like an invisible wall. Let's go check out that megalith right there. And then maybe pass through the archway over there and see what we can find. So like I said, it's been crazy. I apologize though for the delay. There aren't that many ways for me to sort of get the word out. I do try to put in comments when I can. If you guys don't, feel free to follow me on Twitter. I will sometimes post updates there if I have the time. It has just been crazy. The consequences of working essentially in a service profession. Interesting. Okay, there's nothing there. So let's go check out what's on this end of the world, I guess, or of this place. And that's about it. So, you know, we came back, or I came back. We are coming back to Essence, which I'm pretty excited about. I've been looking forward to this game for a very long time, since essentially I heard about it in development. Whoop. No, that's it. Okay, I've reached my invisible wall, so let's start going back. Since I heard about it in development, there's also going to be a video tonight, I'm hoping, for a game called The Signal from Tolva. Now, I'm a little late to the party on that one, and I'll explain more in the video to it, but I'm also pretty excited about that. Oh, man. Well, never mind the nakedness, but check this out. So I thought the sand was wet or, like, shimmering or shiny, but it's not even that. It's, like, pearlescent, right? It's like almost like Mother of Pearl just got crushed up and distributed all the way across. Very cool. Let's see. This, I think, is where we woke up. This, like, Stonehenge-y area there. Fine. And that's, yeah, so there it is. That's the little statue of the child where we got the glowing cube and then turned on the color, essentially, right? Because there is the gate. And if we walk past it towards this direction, we should be able to find the polyhedron. Okay. Very cool. So, now I'm wondering, I mean, whoa. You guys seeing this? Is this just a thing? I'm wondering if that's just a quirk of the geometry of the tree, and it does look like that. It almost, when it was 2D, holy moly, when it's 2D kind of like this, from a distance it almost looked like somebody with long hair and like in a dark robe, flowing robe, standing against the wind, which would have been pretty cool, but that was just my, I don't think it's wishful thinking, I don't think that's really the right term for it, it was just my imagination is probably the right term for it, that's the better term. So there we are. That's our polyhedron friend. What's up, man? Oop. I'm following you now. I know your tricks. You're going to take me to all the interesting places in this world, aren't you? Okay. Right. Oh, hello. Are you... Wait a minute. Yeah, you're going there anyway. I was going to say, like, what the... whatever. Okay. I'm wondering if they're maybe looking at the polyhedrons as they're flying around. Maybe. My past journey seemed to be endless. The days passed by something like progress. How many more challenges are going to wait for me on the other side of the wall? Can I reread? No? No. All right, and it's definitely going down into that crevasse, which I guess is going to lead me to the doorway. What's over here, though? It looks like there might be something. Let's just walk over here real quick, and then we'll go check out that that ravine, canyon, whatever. Yeah. The one thing I have to say about this game as we're sort of walking around is, at the moment, there's not a lot. I'm assuming that maybe it's going to pick up. This seems like a little preamble tutorial area, for lack of a better term. Nope. We're just going to hit a dead end, guys. I think this is what's going to happen right now, but let's go check it out. So there isn't much to see, but on the other hand, it's very relaxing. So it's very different from, for example, the other exploration puzzle games, right? So, for example, Quern or Abduction. We're at the invisible wall. That was like puzzles on puzzles on puzzles. It was puzzle gauntlets. It was a lot of stuff to explore, always things to remember. For now, this seems very much more like walk around, look at things, try and figure out what might be happening, or at least take in the environment and the storytelling. Now, there isn't much, right? But, I mean, obviously there's some megaliths here. There are a bunch of dead trees. I mean, this is basically desolation right here, right? This is like a desolation valley. And, you know, we have the dead ships. We have the dead nautilus shells. There's not a lot that's going on around here. This is just a lot of death. And I am wondering... Everything's very bright, but everything's very bright in that, like, hazy, hot, and dusty sort of way, which stands to serve. This is essentially a desert, right? I mean, this is, in theory, sand. So, we'll see. Yeah, we're going in there. I see a splash of color. interesting. Yeah, I saw this thing. I don't know what that is, but I saw it, and I'm like, yeah, we're going to have to explore that, because that's the most colorful thing I've seen since we turned on the, color. Cool. Okay. We can't touch it or anything, right? Nope. That said, for all the visual storytelling that this game, I'm assuming possesses, given that there isn't much in terms of text, there isn't much in terms of story presented overtly to you, or at least thus far not. I mean, it's probably unfair to judge it by just this little area. I'm sure it's probably going to pick up as we go past the wall. Let's see, what's over here? Okay. That's cool. Hold on. That's very cool. I'm assuming somebody carved that from the living stone, that pillar, to like prop up that giant cliffside, which would be pretty neat. And two more pillars, and we're back in the Desolation Valley. Okay, we're going to go back. Let's go see what's on the other end of this passage, like this other the other side of the T-junction here. I'm assuming we get closer to the wall, closer to the... whatever, the arch, the doorway, the whatever, but we'll see. Ooh, hello. This is early access, so, you know, there's some weird pop-in stuff, that's fine. Is this... can this move? No? Maybe not? Okay. Can... nothing? Can... nope, nothing. Okay. I could have sworn there would be some movement, because look, there's a seam there, but okay. Maybe we have to activate something else somewhere. Maybe we can come back here? I don't know. I guess we'll find out. This is what I'm talking about. Like, like I said, Quern, Abduction, Puzzle Gauntlets, but even games like The Solus Project, right? Or, if we cast our minds back a little further, you know, No Man's Sky. It's a controversial title in and of itself, but those games... yes, you walked around, you experienced. I think Solus Project is a little closer because that's more in terms of like walking around a bespoke, tailored world that's designed to draw you in for exploration. But even that, you know, you had to contend with other things, or we had to contend with other things. So we have to contend, for example, with hunger, with thirst, with sleep, with weather, etc. This, for now, I don't see any sort of needs. I don't see any sort of survival mechanism. Instead, this is purely a walk around and figure things out, or walk around and see things and learn things and try to piece together the story type of game. And I'm all about that. I'm all about that because it gives me an opportunity to talk through it with you guys. It keeps me an opportunity to explore and discover since, you know. Okay, so those are, I guess, lights? Like pathway lights? Is that this what this is? Yeah. Very cool. Let's see, can we jump up here? Here we go. Nope. Come here. Nope. Nothing. Okay. Yeah, so I said, I specifically... Well, that's where I stand. I'm seeing like a glowing gold aura. No? Oh, there's a seam. Alright, maybe we can't quite open that door yet. Let's see what else there is. So if these, by the way, if these have like an energy piece coming through them, does that mean that these are going to start glowing energy maybe? No? No. One thing I will say, you know, obviously we saw the dead ships, and that was pretty cool, and we saw the crystal, that was pretty interesting. I'm wondering how much incentive I have to go ahead and explore off the beaten path, quote-unquote. Or off the main path, maybe is the right term for it. Because it's cool, but I, like... Again, maybe it's unfair to ask this question now. Maybe the point is wait until I get to sort of a... the area beyond the doorway, then we'll go from there. Yeah? Okay. Alright, so there's nothing else. Let's go ahead and stand on this. Sure, why not? Ooh. Cool. Did that thing open? Nope, the doorway's still closed. Fine. Let's walk through here. Okay, I'm seeing another child statue. Our polyhedron friends, and... Yeah, that guy's moving. Okay, fine. Let's see what you got. As long as we know these mysterious and living spirits have been with us, they seem to be thoughts of another world, of another time. Their intentions, however, are obscure. I'm assuming he's talking about the polyhedrons. All right, let's see what else is there. What else there is around here. If anything. No. Can I do something with these, like, hoops? Nope. Okay, cool. Let's see what else we got. More dead trees. I'm really curious. I mean, is that guy going to give me sort of the rundown of the world? Maybe. All right, but before we talk to him, let's go ahead and explore this area up a little bit more. Because I don't know what's going to happen once we speak with him. It, her, whatever. Alright, another one of these doorways, except this time this one's lined in gold. Nope, nothing. The thing is, I'm not even hearing a sound that says that there's like power here or something, right? All these doors look like they're closed. You know what? Just double check, yeah? Nope. No prompts or anything. Okay. Interesting. Alright, let's check out this... You know what this is? So, obviously we're gonna go check out that place right now, but... Very cool. So I thought when I saw this that this lattice work was just like a 2D sprite because it looks 2D, right? Purely like a 2D sprite, essentially. But this is pure, like all carved. Look, it's all textured and intricate in design. Very, very cool. Yeah, I get it, man. You want me to talk to whoever that is. Relax. We're explorers. We're exploring things on our own terms. Okay, can we open this door on our own terms, speaking of? Nope, of course not. Of course not. Why would we ever be able to do that? Okay. Let's go. I guess all that's left is to talk to this person. Hi. It has been a long time that I last saw someone who lives like you. I am the last one who is watching this world, who saw it once so vivid glow, but also its fading beauty. And I know you are searching for an answer, so follow your path that will unfold in truth beyond the wall. May you find what you desire, my arising child. Right. Well, did you... Oh, yeah, I see it. Thanks, man. Okay. So we are going to go through this. Will we go through this? Because I gotta tell ya. Creepy baby children statues do not sit well with me, really. Okay. Okie dokie. So you know what we're gonna do? We're gonna call it here. I'm seeing a couple more statues, and then I think there's something floating over there in a... Yeah, there's another golden aura thing. So we're gonna go hit these two statues, see what they have to say to us, maybe explore down the sides over there. I don't know what's down there. And then we're gonna try and see what happens if we stand next to that rotating black diamond, I guess? And we'll find out. And these things look like... tombstones. Fantastic. Okay, well, I am actually thoroughly intrigued by what is going on in this game. I am assuming that next time we will come back, we will get past the wall, and we will continue exploring. If you guys enjoyed this, like, comment, subscribe, tell a friend. Lets me know that I'm doing something right. Lets me know that you guys want to see more of this stuff. If you have thoughts on this game... You have thoughts on anything else? You guys want to berate me, understandably, for being away for too long? You know, everything's welcome, as always. And in any case, see you all next time. Ba-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-